Idiopathic intracranial hypertension is a disorder where a high pressure in the brain causes the presentation of meth symptoms. This is my little acronym for many eye issues like double vision, tinnitus, and diffuse headaches. It classically affects high-risk patients who are rudely described with the three Fs, female, fat, and 40, and it's associated with the TOAD drugs, tetracycline antibiotics like doxycycline, the oral contraceptive, A vitamins or analogs like Accutane, and Danazol, which is an androgen agonist used in endometriosis. In terms of its pathophysiology, IIH is a disorder of reduced cerebrospinal fluid absorption. Usually, the CSF is absorbed via the arachnoid granulations. These are folds of arachnoid matter that push into the dural sinuses, acting as one-way valves to drain excessive CSF. In IIH, these outflow pathways probably have a higher resistance, which causes increased intracranial pressure and the typical symptoms associated with this. Moving on to its clinical features, remember it causes many eye issues, like diplopia, also known as double vision. This is because the abducens nerve, which controls the lateral rectus muscle, is really sensitive to high intracranial pressures. Consequently, 10% of patients get a cranial nerve 6 palsy. Moreover, visual loss altogether is a worrying complication. As the intracranial pressure increases, the blood supply to the optic nerve sheath gets cut off. This results in bilateral papilledema or optic disc swelling on both sides. Over time, this can progress to visual loss and blindness. Next, a pulsatile tinnitus is common in IIH. Patients often describe hearing rushing water or wind. This is thought to represent vascular pulsations caused by turbulence in the venous sinuses under high pressure. Finally, the most important symptom is a headache. This is often a throbbing pain associated with nausea and vomiting. It's typically aggravated by coughing, worse in the morning, and when lying down, but it should improve by upright posture. When investigating IIH, I want you to remember three key areas of assessment. Firstly, you should always perform a thorough visual examination. This should include a physical exam to check for a cranial nerve 6 palsy, visual acuity testing to check for any visual loss, and fundoscopy to assess for papilledemia. Next, perform an MRI brain. This should help you exclude differentials, which might be intraorbital or intracranial. Finally, a lumbar puncture should be done once you exclude a space-occupying lesion. This classically would show a high opening pressure, which indicates a high intracranial pressure too. Moving on to management, consider lifestyle management, pharmacological treatment, and procedural management. Now, the most effective treatment for idiopathic intracranial hypertension is weight loss. Patients should aim to lose about 5 to 10% of their total body weight. A low sodium diet should be tried to prevent excessive water intake. Finally, consider eliminating potential causal factors like tetracyclines, retinoids, and excessive vitamin A. Pharmacologically, acetazolamide can be used to decrease CSF production. NSAIDs can be used to help with a headache, but importantly, beta blockers or calcium channel blockers should be avoided as they may decrease perfusion of the optic nerve head. Procedurally, serial lumbar punctures can be useful temporizing measures as a prelude to surgery. CSF shunting procedures can be performed for intractable headache or failed medical therapy. Alternatively, optic nerve sheath fenestration can be performed. Now, this is basically where a window is cut into the nerve, allowing CSF to drain into the orbit to reduce papilledema. Let's summarize all of this by going through a couple of mnemonics. Idiopathic intracranial hypertension causes meth symptoms. This stands for many eye issues, tinnitus, and diffuse headaches. It's common in the three Fs on TOADs: female, fat, and 40, using tetracycline, the oral contraceptive pill, vitamin A, and Danazol. Finally, you can remember that you investigate IIH like an MVP, using an MRI, a thorough visual assessment, and a lumbar puncture. Thanks so much for watching Townsend Teachings. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.